In Genesis 1:27, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female created he them. Yet in the year 2022, men possessed by demonic entities are telling you that you're nothing more than a hackable animal.
I think the most important thing to know about living in the 21st century is that humans are now hackable animals. To hack a human being means to understand that human better than he or she understand themselves, which was never possible in history before on a massive scale. Homo sapiens is now acquiring technologies that can either destroy us or upgrade us, but will not leave us as we are. Authority will gradually shift from us to these corporate or government algorithms that will increasingly decide almost everything about our life.
What that man is uttering through his mouth is inspired by Satan and his fallen angels. You're seeing an earthly human speaking, not an animal, an earthly human that needs to repent or he will perish in hell. Yet what has possessed this man is a spirit. It's an entity described in Ephesians 6:12, where we wrestle not against flesh and blood. But listen to this man speak of the fact that according to him and many other scientists and technology advancements around the world, Earth will be dominated by entities. Earth will be dominated by entities.
When Yuval Noah Harari published his first book, Sapiens, in 2014, about the history of the human species, it became a global bestseller and turned the little-known Israeli history professor into one of the most popular writers and thinkers on the planet. But when we met with Harari in Tel Aviv this summer, it wasn't our species' past that concerned him. It was our future. Harari believes we may be on the brink of creating not just a new enhanced species of human, but an entirely new kind of being, one that's far more intelligent than we are. It sounds like science fiction, but Yuval Noah Harari says it's actually much more dangerous than that.
You said, we are one of the last generations of Homo sapiens. Within a century or two, Earth will be dominated by entities that are more different from us than we are different from chimpanzees.
Yeah.
By entities that are more different from us than we are different from chimpanzees.
Yeah.
That freaked me out.
You know, we'll soon have the power to re-engineer our bodies and brains, whether it is with genetic engineering or by directly connecting brains to computers or by creating completely non-organic entities, artificial intelligence, which is not based at all on the organic body and the organic brain. And these technologies are developing at breakneck speed.
If that is true, then it creates a whole other species.
This is something which is way beyond just another species.
Yuval Noah Harari is talking about the race to develop artificial intelligence, as well as other technologies like gene editing that could one day enable parents to create smarter or more attractive children, and brain-computer interfaces that could result in human-machine hybrids.
I am not making these things up. This is what they're blatantly telling you, but most people are asleep. You know, it's no wonder Isaiah 14:14, I will ascend above the heights of the clouds, I will be like the Most High. It's no surprise that Satan wants to be like God. It's no surprise that Satan understands that his time is short and he's at a point that he's convinced humans that we're nothing more than animals. We didn't arrive here just in 2022. This started in our educational system, in schools, when the theory of evolution was introduced. We're in a day and age where you turn on the news and all you see is chaos, where humans do not regard the other life of humans. But what happens to these people as they're indoctrinated in the public school system? They're told consistently that they're nothing more than an accident. They're told consistently that they're nothing more than a monkey. Did they evolve from a monkey? Yet if that's the case, why is China making hybrid monkeys? If that's the case, why is China taking human and monkey DNA, merging them together, and creating mutants?
Human chimeras living among us, it's only science fiction for right now. Yesterday, the Senate passed the Endless Frontier Act, a bill that commits nearly $250 billion to promote emerging technologies so that America can keep pace with Chinese innovation. Back in May, Democrats shot down an important amendment outlawing U.S. participation in research that would create human-animal hybrids, also known as chimeras. China's already doing it, announcing in April that an international team successfully grew human-monkey embryos and sustained them for 20 days in a lab. The only question is, what will they do next? Currently, the National Institutes of Health has banned U.S. funding for chimeric research, but that ban could very well be lifted. And who's to say that these agencies will play by the rules anyway? Remember, President Obama banned funding for gain-of-function research back in 2014, but New York AD found a way around it. It's the NIAID group, and they laundered hundreds of thousands of dollars to the Wuhan Institute of Virology through a nonprofit group called the Echo Health Alliance. The rest is history. Chimeric research is a Pandora's box that's obviously from hell that should not be opened. But the scientific community, spurred on by their own hubris, may very well open it using American taxpayer dollars. And if that happens, the Democrats will have blood on.
You see, they're blatantly telling you that mutants are among us. And when you go to the root of what these people in this world, you may call them the Illuminati, others may call them whatever you want to call these individuals. What I call them is demonically possessed individuals. You see, because there's a future destination for all of us. And there is one way, and his name is Jesus Christ. And he is giving mankind the ability to get into this ark like the days of Noah. Get into the ark. Yet man continuously rejects the fact that Jesus Christ is giving them eternal life. Matthew 25:46, and these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal. There are two places, two destinations, and there is only one way to get life eternal. That way is through Jesus Christ. Yet via technology, they're trying to tell you that you can live eternal apart from Jesus. Isn't that such a satanic thing? I mean, John 10:1 says, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. Satan is a thief. Satan is a robber. He comes to steal your joy. He comes to steal your salvation. He comes to derail you from turning to Jesus Christ. He comes to tempt you. And he's coming to mankind and telling them that you're nothing more than a hackable animal. You're nothing more than a mistake. You're nothing more than something that evolved into what you are, but Satan can make you better via technology. It's Gnosticism. You see, these teachings, they're different variations of the same Gnosticism that you found in all different types of cultures, where in other words, they blame the creator, right? Instead of acknowledging their sin and their part into this whole thing, because man has a choice. You see, God does not need to be like Satan. I wish humanity would open up their eyes and understand the awesomeness and the power of God. It gets me very upset to hear these people say that they want to hack the human. But it makes me even more sadder to see the humans that are willing for it to actually happen. God does not need a totalitarian surveillance system. You know why? Because God is omnipresent and God sees all. God does not need to build technology to track human beings, because God is God and God knows everything you do. God knows when you delete your cookies. God knows when you delete your browsing history. Oh, you think you can hide from God? See, in technology, you can use an IP system. You can use different types of things to avoid being tracked. But there is a God who knows everything you do when you get up and when you go to bed. And he even knows what has tempted you and what you're thinking of doing tomorrow. But God knows it, and God convicts you to bring you to repentance so that you can have everlasting life. Satan wants to track you through technology so that then he can tempt you and lead you straight into the pits of hell. This is why when you watch something that you should not watch, all of a sudden you start getting all sorts of crazy ads, pop-ups here, this and that, tempting you to fall deeper into that sin. All this talk of UFOs, UFO phenomenons, we can't no more not talk about it, they're telling you. Why do these UFOs operate in the darkness? Why do these beings operate in the dark? When you start hearing of the stories of abductions that have been stopped in the name of Jesus Christ, why does Satan operate in the darkness?
You know, I was dropped in my bed. Before that, I had no clue that anything like that had ever happened to me. Didn't expect it to. It was the movies. It was Hollywood. It was fun to look at, but when I opened my eyes, there was a gray alien within inches of my face, and I actually felt his breath on my skin. I turned away to get away from him and fell back to sleep. The next morning, my son opened my eyes by saying, "That wasn't an alien, Mom, it was a demon." I got on the internet, I went to the library, I stumbled across Joe Jordan, who opened my eyes even more and reminded me that I did already have the authority as a born-again Christian to make this go away. About 2 months later, it happened again, and as they approached my bed, I just frankly said no 3 times, claiming the authority of the blood of Christ, and they disappeared into thin air. And now I tell my story because I want people to know, if you seek this stuff out, you will find it. It is real, but it's not what Hollywood is telling you it is.
Why do these beings always show up when people are trying to rest? And sure, these people are accountable as well, because many of them have opened up spiritual craziness in their house by doing some witchcraft and all sorts of crazy stuff. But why the darkness? God operates in the light. God cannot be bypassed. God knows all that's going to happen, all that will happen. And he tells you very clearly that you need to come out from this harlot system. In Revelation 18 verse 4, "And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not her plagues." God is warning you that something is coming, and judgment is coming to Babylon. And it tells you in Revelation 18:3, "For all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornications." All the merchants of this world. Judgment is coming.
You apply to the bank to get a loan, it's an algorithm that decides. You apply to get a job, it's an algorithm. Even questions like what to study or whom to marry will increasingly be decided by these algorithms. To stay in the game, you need to get to know yourself better. Also, in order to protect yourself against being manipulated.
And they're clearly telling you that an algorithm is going to determine your job, is going to determine even your marriage, is going to determine your real estate, your banking, your security, your food source. I want to tell you today not to be intimidated when they keep on talking down upon you who decides to stay out of the harlot system. Did David not fight a Goliath? Did David not fight a Goliath? He was a Nephilim. 2 Samuel 21, 20-21 tells you, "And there was yet a battle in Gath, where a man of great stature, that had on every hand 6 fingers and on every foot 6 toes, 24 in numbers, and he was also born to the giant. And when he defied Israel, Jonathan, the son of Shimeah, the brother of David, slew him." What human being that God has created, okay? God's creation has 6 fingers and 6 toes. An uncommon being it was, born to the giant. Yet he was no match to David. No match to David. You see, what they're telling you is that via technology, they can heal you. But via the Holy Spirit of God, can you not pray upon others in the name of Jesus Christ and God can heal them? And even your own life, can you via the Holy Spirit of God not get healing if you turn to Jesus Christ and God decides to heal you? They'll tell you that via technology and machine learning, you can discern the future, but you can do the same via the Holy Spirit of God. Oh yes, when you're in tune with the Holy Spirit of God will warn you don't go that way, will warn you be watchful for that, will warn you be cautious. And you don't need to download no app. Oh no, you have the power of the Holy Spirit who goes before you and warns you and cautions you and strengthens you. And then you know what? It actually gives you the words of what to speak. Because you see, they'll tell you with technology, you can use Google Translate. With technology, you can have that extra knowledge. Elon Musk says, we're already cyborgs because with your phone, you're smarter. You're much, much more smarter when you're filled with the Holy Spirit of God. Because in Luke 12:12, for the Holy Ghost shall teach you in the same hour what ye ought to say. Because when you're full of the Holy Spirit of God, no algorithm cannot perform what comes out of your lips, because what comes out of your lips is straight from the Holy Spirit of God when you're in tune with God 100%. With technology, Satan will tell you that you can live eternally by mind uploading. Well, Jesus Christ is giving you eternal life by just submitting to him today and repenting and turning to Jesus Christ. My friend, we need not to be intimidated by what we are about to see. God has raised you up in this generation, empowered you with the power of the Holy Spirit to endure unto the end. And if you're not born again, if you're not born again today, John 3:3, Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Would you like today, would you like to be one of those that via the Holy Spirit, you don't need a microchip, you don't need an app, you don't need a phone to be able to discern and avoid dangers? Would you like to be one of those that in the name of Jesus, you can cast out devils? Would you like to be one of those that is at a point that you're one with the Father, right? You're living in tune with the Creator, and you can live eternally in Him. Today is that day that you can turn to Jesus Christ. And if you've backslidden, if you're living a life right now that you know you shouldn't be living, listen, we've all been there. Today is the day you can make that decision to say, I'm going to come out of this harlot system. I'm not going to allow the fear that they're implanting in us right now. No Nephilim, no entity, no demon can touch you without going through God first. You understand that? And the one that you serve has already told you what happens at the end. Satan is defeated in the name of Jesus Christ. And today is the day for you to get right with God, for you to renew your walk with God, for you to turn that frown upside down, and for you to realize one thing, that there's only one way. And man, that one way is beautiful. His name is Jesus. Heavenly Father, we come before you today thanking you for what you've done for us. Because all you give unto humanity is free. Do you want to live forever? Heavenly Father is giving you eternal life for free. Do you want to be set free today? Do you want to get that anxiety out of your system? There is one who says that you can cast all of your anxieties, all of these anxieties that we have, taken upon him today. There's one who says that you don't need an app. You don't need a trackable device. No, all you need is him. And he's given to you these living waters for free. The world will tell you you can't get a job because these algorithms won't hire you. There's one who says that he's your provider and he's the King of Kings. There's one that says, there are humans that say that you can't get married because the algorithm won't approve that you marry another person. There's one who says, once again, I repeat it, that's your provider and he knows who you're going to marry. He knows when you're going to marry them and he's going to find you the right person. We're going to endure until the end in the name of Jesus Christ. And we will not allow an entity. We will not allow a spirit, because fear is a spirit. May the Lord rebuke in the name of Jesus the spirit of fear. Do not operate via fear. Operate with a mindset that God has already conquered, in the same way that David was able to defeat a Nephilim in the name of Jesus Christ. There is not an entity. It could be made by Elon Musk itself. It's defeated by the power of Jesus Christ. Believe it in the name of Jesus. And there's one thing that technology cannot do. It cannot give you peace. Do you need peace today? Right there where you're at. Let's call upon the Lord. We need you, Heavenly Father. We need you in our lives. You know that there are people today that are watching this video that are broken. They are broken inside. Their marriage is going through difficulties. Their family is just in utter chaos. Their friendships are breaking apart and it's hurting them. Their finances are going up, they're going down. There's so much chaos when you turn on the television. In the name of Jesus Christ, give them the healing today. Let them understand that they can call upon you to be restored. And hey, listen to me. God will restore you, okay? God knows how hard it's been. God knows how hard it is. But God also knows what he has in store for you. Today is not the time to waver. We're not in a day that we should waver. We're in a day that we should submit ourselves more to God. In the name of Jesus, amen. May God bless you all. Thank you for taking time to watch the video. Thank you for taking time to pass by, as you always do. Would you please consider taking 5 or 10 seconds to share this video? Text it to a friend. Share it on a platform that you use. That would greatly be appreciated. Thank you for all that you do for the ministry. Thank you for your support. And thank you for your prayers. And may God bless you all always. Remember that God is in control. God is in control. God's got your back. God bless.